morning, Senator Stavisky. Today is Tuesday, April 9th, 2019. Joining us today, Senator Addabbo, Senator Serrano, Senator Martinez, Senator Stavisky, and I know our ranking member, Senator Betty Little, is on her way from another committee meeting. But I believe, do we have a quorum?
Yeah.
All right, so we will have seven bills to be considered by the committee today. Let's start. First bill by Senator Skoufis, S-1777.
An act to validate certain acts of the Newburgh Enlarged City School District and the Chester Union Free School District with regard to certain capital improvement projects.
Any questions? Any discussion?
Move the bill.
Second?
Second.
Thank you, Senator Stavisky. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any that rec? Okay, the bill is reported to Finance. Second bill by Senator Metzger, S-2611.
An act relating to validating certain acts by the Roscoe Central School District relating to final building cost reports required to be filed with the Education Department.
Any questions on the bill? Yes, Senator Stavisky.
This, I think, was vetoed.
Yes.
Have they resolved the issues in the veto?
Well, in the veto message, the governor said to resolve it in the budget. In the budget, in the budget, we did put in a blanket forgiveness provision that would apply to Roscoe as well as districts throughout the state, which was ultimately not accepted by the executive, so we are proceeding. Any other questions on the bill?
Thank you for your explanation. Same explanation for the maintenance of effort in higher education.
Yes, right?
Yes.
We know this issue. So, a motion?
Move the bill.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Bill is reported to Finance. Third bill by Senator Gorin, S-2976.
An act to legalize, validate, ratify, and confirm the actions of the Huntington Union Free School District, notwithstanding the failure to timely file final building cost reports with the Education Department.
I'll wait for a minute. We've been joined by Senator Little, Senator Lanza, Senator Metzger.
This is a marathon of committees today.
I'm sorry. I'm going to take this today.
You have six?
Oh, my days today. So I'll give you a minute to catch your breath. We are on the third bill by Senator Gorin. The first two bills will report to Finance. Thank you.
Okay.
I believe we moved. So on Senator Gorin's bill, any questions or discussion? Motion?
Motion to move the bill.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? And without rec, okay, the bill is referred to Finance. Now, the fourth bill by Senator Gorin, S-2977.
An act in relation to legalizing, validating, ratifying, and confirming a transportation contract for the Cold Spring Harbor Central School District.
Any questions or discussion on the bill? A motion?
Motion.
I'll second.
Senator Little? Senator Metzger, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is referred to Finance. Next, by Senator Metzger, S-4333.
An act to legalize, validate, ratify, and confirm the actions of the Monticello Central School District, notwithstanding the failure to timely file final building cost reports with the Education Department.
Any questions or discussion? Motion? Senator Little?
Second.
Thank you, Senator Martinez. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Without rec, bill is referred to Finance. Next, by Senator Harkum, S-4949.
An act to validate certain actions of the Manitowoc Central School District with regard to certain capital improvement projects.
Any questions?
No.
Senator Little, are you moving the bill?
Move the bill.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is referred to Finance. Last, by Senator Seward, S-4957.
An act authorizing the Skaneva Central School District to apply to the Commissioner of Education to receive an apportionment to be used for services and expenses of such school district and to support its educational programs and any liability in carrying out the functions and responsibilities of such a district.
Any questions? Senator Little?
No, I guess
okay.
So.
Motion?
Motion.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Without rec, the bill is referred to finance.
They're mostly all the same thing, they're just different wording on some of them.
Yes.
Little confusing.
I know, and I think the answer, as was explained to me, is that there were reasons for the penalties deal with the technical failures in particular areas. This mirrors that language. And the last one by Senator Seward is a forwarding of lottery aid advance to help them in a particularly difficult situation.
And it is a 30-year?
Payback.
Payback?
Yes, on the lottery aid advance.
Do we usually do that?
I have seen it done in my district multiple times. Multiple times, I said.
How much of an advance, you don't get a 30-year advance.
How much do they get, you know?
No, you're only able to advance what your estimate is for your September lottery payment, but you repay it over 30 years.
Okay.
It's 1/30th of the value that you repay, so it has some...
So there's no...
Has a cash value.
Yeah, it has a cash value.
So it's like a loan?
Correct, it's a loan. It's an advance.
Imagine from your city to...
It's not an advance of their own, what they're due.
It is from the subsequent year.
Why do they have to change that?
Because you have to have a, because otherwise you wouldn't have proceeds to be able to make payments.
Do it next year. I don't think I've had anybody do it, so, out of 49 districts, so.
Well, we tried to...
They have, I don't know.
We tried to help Senator Seward with a particular problem in his district.
Yeah.
Using this, and Georgia helped him figure out how to...
Well, I've never seen it before, so it's interesting.
That's why I asked the question. We've done that kind of thing with East Ramapo, some of the other districts advanced them.
We had Syracuse, there's been others that have had advances. Okay, that concludes our meeting.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you very much.
They're getting an advance, they're getting an advance.